Hi everybody, how is it going today, traders? It's now the end of the month, Wednesday, January 31st, about 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, and I hope you guys have had a very profitable, but more importantly, safe month, because this was literally one of the most turmoil months that I've ever seen in cryptocurrency history. Never have I seen Bitcoin fall this much before, in terms of dollars, of course, because we were at our all-time high. And at the same time, percentage-wise, I've seen Bitcoin fall about this much before, like in, I think, 2015 or something. And it's been a very scary time in the market. So during times like this, we absolutely have to exercise caution and try to be a few steps ahead of the game while having a game plan backed up as well, right? So if you guys enjoy these videos that I'm making, I would also appreciate an upvote on Steam. Make sure you guys do that. And also like, subscribe, and share the stuff on YouTube and on Twitter as well. And if you guys especially think I'm doing a great job and I've tremendously improved your game, consider buying me a beer or a coffee and donating to the Luna cryptocurrency piggy bank, but don't ever feel obligated. Someone suggested that I always say this little spiel at the beginning and end of every video because some people are actually very appreciative and you know, they want to let me know. But other than that, let's get into Bitcoin, okay? Yesterday, we were talking about how this RSI is acting as a support, right? Both of these right here. These guys are acting as a support. So now we are reaching a very critical moment for Bitcoin right now. It is extremely critical the next few hours, actually, okay? This RSI support must hold. If it does not hold, I will guarantee a 9.3K range, okay? So we are talking about two major supports. One, this previous resistance on RSI, and two, this horizontal one right here. If this RSI ends up breaking down, folks, let me show you what I mean. If it does not do this, and instead it does this, okay, where it breaks the horizontal one and trends down here, we might end up seeing something like that, which will be very ugly. Now, I'm not going to keep you guys for too long. I'm going to talk about some very quick things here that I've already drawn ahead of time because I value your time and I don't want to hold it up too long. This is actually the third time I made this video and I was goofing around in a lot of the videos, and then I realized that I should probably be respectful to your guys' time and the severity of this issue right now. So there's not really a lot of time to be joking around during critical moments like this because a lot of people's money could be on the line. And I know that you guys respect me as an analyst, therefore I will reciprocate it with a very serious type of tone as well for Bitcoin. I want you guys to know that we are now apexing into an ascending triangle. Now let me show the people that don't know what an ascending triangle is. Sorry, a descending triangle. I will be correcting myself right there, okay? So there are two types of, there's three types of triangles really, okay? We'll just talk about the three basic types and not falling or rising wedges, okay? There's, first of all, I don't like red. I'm going to grab blue here, or green rather. So there are these types of triangles like this, which is an ascending triangle, okay? I'm just gonna, for simple annotation, I'm just gonna call it A, B, C, D, E in here, okay? So I know that there are some of you expert Elliott Wave analysts out there that will say this is not right and it should be annotated differently, but let's just call it A, B, C, D, E for simplicity, okay? An A, B, C, D, E triangle likes to do this, right? Where this, this was a wave up here, then it does an A, B, C, D, E type of correction, and then it attempts to break out to the upside. This is a very bullish pattern, and a very bullish pattern, but it does not always break upwards, all right? Now, the second type of triangle is, of course, these ones, which is a descending triangle like that. And these generally come in A, B, C, D, and E, like that, okay? And then this, when it hits this peak, it breaks down. And the way we think of these triangles is that it gets a series of lower highs, but it gets the same lows. And that's not good because it cannot simply get higher, but it's always getting the same bottom. So we ask ourselves, how many times can it pound on the bottom before it actually breaks down? And then, of course, there are these types of triangles as well. Oh, by the way, this one is more bearish than bullish. And then there are these ones, which are symmetric triangles, and we just simply don't know which way it's going to break. And these ones are very hard to play. Now, what we clearly see in here, which I hope we can all agree to, is that Bitcoin is now making a descending triangle with this massive resistance trend line up there, right? And this whole area is acting as a support. How did we get this region before as a support? We got this region by taking the last heavy activity, high price action area over there. We see these wicks poking through it, right? And we actually see it not holding, to be quite honest. We see the volume slowly diminishing right here, which is, it could be a sign that it's just not interested yet, but usually volume will pick up when there's more activity to push it up, for example, okay? So we are seeing the volume completely slowly die off at the moment. So right now, a bearish scenario is in play. What I highly recommend for people to do right now is this. So please take my advice very seriously. This is not financial advice. This is strategy. Okay? This is strategy. I will basically be putting I'll be looking right around 10K range, to be quite honest. Okay? I'm going to be looking at the 10K ranges specifically to see which way it breaks with conviction. If it breaks down over here, just as an example, and you see this criteria met, so please remember this. You see a long candle like that coming down, a big candle, and you also see heavy, heavy volume, okay? We're talking about pretty big volume, all right? If you see these criteria met, you guys know what to do, bears. This is shorting the market right there. It'd be a very wise option. I'm not a financial advisor, keep in mind. I guess it's just more so me speaking about what I am going to do on my end. I will short Bitcoin 100%, and I will make an immense profit from it if I see volume with a candle and a confirmation of a downtrend, okay? For example, right here, this candle right there, what do you guys think I did here when this volume, right? When this volume formed, and also this candle right here formed, right? I shorted it, of course. I shorted it when it bounced right back up there. It made entire sense for me to short the market there, right? So I will short it again if something does happen like that down. And here is the possible play, basically, right? We're talking about a possible play right there, up 3.22, risk to reward ratio, stop loss around 10K, and targeting about the lower region that we got last time, around 9,400 range right here. So if these criteria are met, I will absolutely consider it. And the next one is the bullish scenario as well. And the bullish scenario goes like something like this, where you guys wait patiently for a successful close on whatever time frame that you guys use for your confirmation. You wait for a successful close outside of this re trend on trend line resistance, and you also make sure that the volume is there so you don't get thrown over. Throw over is basically something that goes like this, where the bears want to trap you, where they'll throw it over quickly, right? And then instead of getting a big candle like that, what ends up happening is you get bear trapped, right? Let's say you get bear trapped, and there is actually now a wick that just pokes up like that, and now it's too late. You guys are now bear trapped. You're bull trapped, right? And that ends up happening. So you want to make sure you get that confirmation. If we get this type of confirmation, then the very logical play would be to target something around, around right here, first of all, 10,400 ranges. And we say 10,400 because we see a lot of activity around here. So that'd be a very logical place to target with the stop loss slightly below here. So it's still a very decent risk to reward, 1.42, right? That's just for average. And then maybe 4 or 5%. And then if we break through that range, I would consider taking some profit here, right? Just to get some of the house money. So if you buy back in, then you can easily just use the house money, which is not really yours because you won it already, right? To buy back into a position and guarantee some profit. And then the next case is targeting this range over here, where we saw a lot of resistance, support and resistance, which is now a hard resistance. So there are two possible cases, one here And one right there. You guys can pause the video and just take a look at it on the side. So that is pretty much the bull and the bear scenario that is in play for the next few days. And something is going to happen in the next 6 hours, like 7 hours. We're reaching a very decisive moment here, right? Like in my time, it's about midnight, like midnight where it says the date that's reaching the apex here. So if something is going to happen, literally, like we'll say 8 hours, 10 hours, okay? So we have to be watching this moment. This is going to be a very critical moment for Bitcoin where it will decide whether it goes down to the 93, 9400 ranges or whether we go back up to 500, a 10,500 range. So this is basically going to decide, will we go up 500 or $1,000, or will we go down 500 or $1,000? And as a day trader, I stay out of the market when it's consolidating into these types of patterns, and I will play the breakout because I want to be very patient about it. I want to be rational about it, and I want to also confirm a trend. And I promise you guys that I will be making a trend confirmation video extremely soon. I'm just figuring out how to put it together right now, and it will come together. And I'm just trying to appeal to different levels of experience as well, right? I want to make it a basic and advanced, but at the same time, I want to make sure that someone or that everyone will take something away from these videos. So for now, in terms of confirmation, I'm talking about it very briefly in terms of just breaking out with a candle and a volume confirmation. So once again, I highly urge the day traders out there right now to pay attention. Go to your chart, draw in this descending triangle. And you guys need to wait right around here or here, whether it breaks up or breaks down, okay? But right now, from the way I see it, it looks like we're losing steam because of volume, but at the same time, we're also getting this type of trend right here as well, right? We're getting this type of trend that looks like it's apexing right into here. So getting a lot of mixed signals right now on all time frames. Nothing is actually decisively telling us what to do right now. There's not a single thing that's telling us. People will say this looks like it's gonna cross over, but you never know. Look how far the MACD got down before. Everybody thought it was gonna cross over right here, or sure, it crossed over a little bit, and ooh, that really hurt the last few days, right? So please exercise extreme caution during these times. Take my advice with a grain of salt, but definitely do consider it as well, like I know you folks always do. Other than that, I really appreciate you guys watching this video of mine and the love and support you've given me. Please make sure to upvote it on Steam it, and make sure you also like and subscribe to these videos on YouTube and on Twitter as well. And if you guys want to let me know I'm doing a fantastic job, you're welcome to buy myself and Luna a beer for the cryptocurrency piggy bank there. Other than that, have yourselves a great day, traders, and please exercise extreme caution. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video, and have a great afternoon. Bye now.